the spiritual connection and the way that your brothers come together from all over the place, you know, to meet at this water place, bro. Yeah, look how beautiful it is.
It's incredible, and people always ask me about Bell's Beach. What's Bell's Beach? What is it? Well, anything that's gathered at this sort of collection of all brothers on behalf of surfing and saltwater business, you know, I go, this place must be a spiritual, powerful land because we're all here.
When I go home, bro, to you know, Mungandai and sit on the riverbank, it feels like a the same kind of connection, just sitting on the little tiny riverbank, bro, you know? In the afternoon when the sun goes down, bro.
Beautiful, bro.
You know, catching yellow belly.
And unreal.
Yeah.
Well, we're made of water. We're mostly water, right? So it just seems like getting in this salt water, it's a full charge. The majority of the oxygen comes out of the sea, from the plankton, it's not from the trees. So to be getting in the ocean, which is the purest form of oxygen, it's a full oxygen bath.
Look at the horizon, man. Look how magic that is. You know what I was freaking out on last night? Look at the Southern Cross there, bro. Look at the Southern Cross.
It's like
bang, bang. It's like that big, bro. It's like in the sky, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's
right there. So I know where we are, man. Mungandai is that way. Western Australia is that way.
Sydney's up here.
Gomeroi that way, you know?
Yeah. There are boys.
Yeah.
So you've been concentrating right where the positioning it is now, where you're located.
Yeah. It gives me an indication of where Mungandai is, bro.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, you know?
You love it.
Yeah.
You can't get the home out of this ladder, can you?
You know?
No.
Go walk down this way.
Walk down
and, you know, that's why it feels amazing here, you know?
When we talk about man's business in Indigenous culture, I go, I always try to imagine how this country was when you could walk it and do whatever you want. And then I go, well, you know, a couple hundred years ago they started fencing this and Indigenous people couldn't move around how they had to move around and couldn't go through their natural ceremonies and initiations. A lot of stuff looked like it might have been squashed. And I always used to think, you know, like in the football and the boxing, Indigenous man's business was alive. That's where man could find their strength and find their sharpening of the spear, so to speak, yeah. And I don't think people were aware that it's also so alive in salt water and man's business in the ocean.
And it's so amazing because we're at the bottom of the country and this is where these big storms hit and this is what's built this most amazing
landscape.
It's like a coliseum. I'll show you how the swirls work.
I'm
right?
Mad.
Let's draw the coast as it's tucked in. It's got all that and it sets rings of water that pop out. And those rings are in fact the waves. So you can see that right now that rock's dropped there and it's put rings out and those rings have hit the back part of the point here. And then they'll just keep coming and coming and that's what waves are.
Back when we paint, like for our water hole, we do this here, look.
Yeah, right. It's similar.
Very similar, bro.
It's beautiful.
And that's like our river systems, bro. That's just like water holes, you know what I mean? Like when we paint,
it's beautiful.
Got painting hand, you know.
And the good thing here, no one can steal your painting because she's going to wash it away, right?
Yeah.